I need to get this gold more pure so that when I make more coins or jewelry out of it, it doesn't crack and break. A couple weeks ago, I posted a video where I went to Baltimore, Maryland with Carrie and the Ami channel, and we made some gold coins. But the problem was my gold had just a little bit of impurities in it, which caused it to crack when we were rolling out the gold to form the blanks to make the coins.
They crack.
Right away.
Just like that.
Is it because of the crystal structure, you think, or impurities?
Yeah.
Well, we're gonna remelt it and find out.
We got it rolled, right? Are you happy with that?
We definitely, we have to watch some of these corners, and that'll be a remelt, but we can definitely get some coins cut out of this.
My goal today is to refine this gold, remove the last little bit of impurities without acids, and hopefully we can have some more malleable gold that we can roll and form much, much easier. I'm gonna try and explain to you what I got set up here. So everything's cool now, it's not plugged in. But the idea is we're gonna take our little melting dish and our gold. There's a little bit of borax in there that's gonna absorb any oxides we create from oxidizing the base metals. And what I've done in the past is you put this thing in here, you get it up to about 1900 degrees Fahrenheit, the gold melts, the oxides form a little skin on the surface, and then they roll off and are absorbed, in this case, by the borax. But with this button, I put it in here and it just has a nice mirror finish on it. There's no oxides forming, no anything. But I think when I get it up to temperature, I can show you. When I blow on it, you get a little oxide skin forming. And I don't know if that's like rolling the metal or you're introducing oxygen right on top of the button and it's oxidizing. So there's a little bit of junk still left in this gold button. And what I've heard is as much or as little as 0.2% of lead or bismuth or tellurium will cause it to be brittle and crack. And you can see right here on the edge, I think you can see that little cracks from when we tried to hammer it when we were back with Carrie a couple of months ago. So what I'm going to do, and this is goofy, right? We're proof of concept here. I've got a little aquarium pump hooked up to some hose and some galvanized pipe, which you're probably not supposed to do, but we're gonna go with it anyway, because it's what I have. I'm gonna drill a hole right down the top of the furnace. I'm gonna put the pipe down so it's right on top of the gold in the melting dish. And then when the aquarium pump pumps oxygen, it's just gonna blow air right on top of that molten gold puddle. And my hope is the oxygen that the aquarium pump introduces can oxidize that last little bit of base metals, whether it's bismuth or arsenic or lead or whatever it is, get it out of there so we can have a nice, pure gold, silver, precious metal button that we can then hammer and manipulate into whatever shape we want. Okay, here we go. There, looks about good, huh? I can always come back and plug this hole with a little bit of KO wool or something. So, yeah, let's go for it. Stainless is hard, and I want to be a little bit gentle as well. I don't want to blow through the whole top of the furnace. Gentle, gentle. Don't get in a hurry. That work? Uh-oh. Ah, dang it. I drilled through one of my coils. Uh-oh. Yeah. I guess that's a case of measure twice and drill once, huh? See if we can fix that. All right, guys, little change of plan. I screwed that first furnace up. So why have one when you can have two? I kind of rehabbed this one. This one had stuff splattered all over the inside. But what we're going to do is we're just going to heat up our gold. Rather than try and drill a bunch of holes in it, I'm just going to take that pipe. And I just want to confirm that this will actually work. I just want to take that pipe, shove it in here when the gold's molten. And then I can just blow down that tube or turn the pump on and see if we can actually get some oxides forming on the surface of that gold. So I got to get this heated up first. I forgot to do a very important part. I want to weigh it before I melt it. and see how much we reduce the size of this button by. So it's 44.02 grams, 03 grams, somewhere in there. Looks like 02. So that's our starting weight. Now, I know some of my viewers that have seen me do this a bunch of times are going to be asking, why aren't I using a cupel? Why am I doing this borax method? And the reason is typically the last little bit of base metals to go out of the button can be lead, it can be bismuth like we talked about, but also copper and iron are some of the last things to go out of the button. And if I just put it in a cupel and I have some iron oxides or some copper oxides, those don't become molten at the temperatures we're at in our furnace. And so what ends up happening is they just form a skin over the top of the button and then the whole process stops. So using that molten borax ring around the bottom of that button, it'll pull those oxides that are solid, even if they're solid on the button, it'll pull them off and refresh that surface so we can continue to oxidize whatever other base metals are in there. So that's why I'm not using a cupel for that last little half a percent or percent of material that we have in there. Here's something I'll throw out there. I'm trying to clean up the shop a little bit. And these are all my old cupels that I've used over the last couple of years. And I'm looking to get rid of them. And a lot of you guys will email me and say, hey, do you have any cupels you want to get rid of? Or I want to reprocess your cupels. So I'm going to bag these up. I don't know what they're worth. I'm going to put them on eBay for $1 and start the auction. That way you guys determine their value. But there'll be 3 or 4 bags. And it's a lot of them have gold in them. I know there's gold in them because I've reprocessed them in the past. But anyway, check out the eBay listing. I'll put a link in the description below. And you guys can play with some of these used cupels. All right, we are up to temperature. We're about 2,000 degrees. And I want to show you. The gold's molten there. And it's just an absolute mirror finish. There's nothing going on the top of that button. Now let's see if I can do this. Okay, I'm gonna blow down this pipe. Ready? So whatever you do, don't suck back up that pipe when it's in the furnace. But I don't know if you could see, there was little swirls that started on the surface of that gold button when I blew on it. I'm gonna kind of try and refine my system here a little bit, but I think we've proved the concept that you've got to blow air on that thing and you can remove further base metals. All right, we're gonna try this system. I've got our furnace back up to 2000. We're molten in there. I've got my little goofy aquarium pump set up. There's a little vent hole right in the top of this furnace. And I'm thinking if I just put the aquarium pump there, then we can pump air into the chamber and at least we have some air movement, because right now when it's all closed up, I think it's pretty much a vacuum. All right, we're going here. Let's see what we got. Oh yeah, there's a little bubble floating around on there. So it's working. Got to wait till that thing is a mirror finish. So the whole idea here is I'm using the propane burner that I do for my smelting furnace with the idea that I can control the oxygen mixture and make it a real oxidizing flame, but keep it hot enough to keep the gold molten. And you can see the beads of oxides rolling off the surface, and that blower is blowing oxygen and propane, and there's enough oxygen to oxidize all the base metals in there. It's rolling the gold around, so it's exposing all the metals in there. And after about 5 minutes, it really, really came very nice and clean. So I think that propane burner is a great way to finish off the refining of the gold. Okay, wow, that was a little bit trickier at the end than I was hoping for, but I got my button out. Hold on. Let's get it cooled off. Let's see what we got here. So that is interesting. It has a much different finish than when it went in. When it went in, it was kind of, I don't know, it had like this hexagon look on it, like you could see the crystals in it. And remember on the bottom, there was a bunch of bubbles. Now there's no bubbles at all. There's still a little bit of a texture to it, but I think that might be from the borax underneath the on the melting dish. The surface kind of cooled gradually from one side to the other, so that's why you see that pattern there. But I don't know if you can see it on the camera. I hope you can see it, but when I put it in the propane furnace blower there, all kinds of stuff was rolling off this button. At first I thought it was beads of borax, but I think it was chunks of oxide, or not chunks, but molten oxides rolling off. And then after about 5 minutes, it completely stopped, and it was just a nice mirror finish. And this characteristic is so much different than when it went in. So let me get some of the borax off of there, and then I want to get it weighed and see how much material we lost.
Just cleaning it off and muriatic acid, a little hydrochloric acid, should eat up that borax pretty quick. And my sad little hot plate here still is doing the job.
All right, now let's see how much it weighs. If I remember right, we start with 44.03. Now we're at 43.85, so we lost 0.2 grams, which is about 0.5%, I believe. It looks a lot better. I mean, it looks way better. So we pulled something out of it. But now the real question is the hammer test. I want to make sure that this thing can get beat on without cracking. Okay, here we go. Look at that. You can see the hammer dents in it. Oh! Not a crack in sight. Let me switch to my other camera so you can see it up close. Look at that. You can see every little hammer ridge. There's no cracks on the edge there. Whatever that 0.5% was we pulled out made the difference. Let me hammer on a little more, see how thin I can get it. I'm not a professional. Sure seems to be working well. Well, I just beat the living tar out of it, and I think the term is drawing. I drew the gold out into, you know, kind of wafer thin. It started, I don't know if I just got it too thin, and there's a little crack kind of forming here, but, I mean, look at that. I can roll it. I can roll it into a little curlicue there. Back out. So I think that works. All right, Carrie, well, I got it figured, so next year I can come out with some really nice pure gold and we can make something cool.
So
So that solved a bunch of problems and answered a few questions for me. You gotta essentially jet oxygen down onto that molten gold to get it purified to where you can work it. If you guys are interested in any of the coins we made, there's still a few left on eBay, so check those out. We will have more coming next season, as well as a lot more mining content. Season 3 is gonna get started here in the next couple months. So stay tuned for all that. Don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss anything, and we'll see you on the next video.